Ben Gay. That's what I smell. Who would have thought that deleting all my Skyrim videos and then uploading a new one, the first word in the first new batch of Skyrim videos would be Ben Gay?
Yes?
The people that live below me, I think they make their own Bengay using the stove, and it burns, and then their smoke detector goes off, and then I start smelling the weirdest stuff coming through the air vents and crap in the building. So where are we? We are in Donster. Looking for Velia's ex-boyfriend.
Welcome back. It's always a pleasure to see you. Goodbye.
Let's get the lighting right. I want to be in the right spot when we record this because...
Yes, my Thane?
Oh.
Do let me know if I can be of service.
Let's all get on our positions here.
I'm so happy for the loot. I'm so happy that Wilbert wants to give me lessons. But I really want to get my flute back first.
I'm holding a torch so I can see what's going on in here. Anyway, that was uneventful. So now we're in Markarth. I'm just sort of racing through the whole flute quest thing. Still getting used to the EMB that I'm using.
The finest jewelry in all of Markarth.
Those of you that have watched my Skyrim videos in the past know what my old EMB looked like, so this is way different. Specifically, I was looking underneath the rocks, the rock wall and the shadows. I don't want my shadows to be black. I don't want the shading to be black.
Craftsmanship in every piece.
So I was playing around with the gamma setting in my game, just checking underneath the cliffs here where it's dark, underneath the outcropped rocks and things. I was just seeing if it's black or if it's just darkish. It's not looking too bad. I've got this auto brightness adjustment going on when I point the camera at different light levels on the screen. It's like a light meter. It automatically senses the dark and the light, and it tries to balance it out somehow. It's got some fancy script. I don't understand how it works. I don't even know what language it's using. It took forever to figure out how to get the letterbox to work. Because it comes with no letterbox. It has the code to turn on the letterbox, but the code's either broken or I don't know how to use it. There's no comments in the program to explain how to adjust any of the settings. So I just brute forced the letterbox to get it to look like this. So I don't think it's running any letterbox code. It's just Driscoll hacking the code to make it do something. This ENB is, what, 3 or 4 years old? No one uses it except me, apparently, so... I'm talking to myself when I go on the forum saying, hey, how do I make this letterbox work? And all I hear is crickets. The person that made this ENB is long gone. Don't think they even do Skyrim anymore. Yeah, see right there, it's pretty dark. Underneath this bridge, it looks kind of darkish. For the time of day, it just feels darkish. So I'll tweak the gamma a little bit. Okay, now it's a little bit lighter underneath the bridge. Maybe too light? If I let in too much light, then the bloom starts to go overboard with itself. Okay, so I saved the game, came back in. I'm continuing on. Of course, when I loaded the game up, it picked a different weather pattern to use for the outdoors. So all my lighting was for naught, because now it's a whole different weather thing going on. Still not too darkish on the cliffs. Oh, something's loading. What's going on here? I guess there's more clouds.
Hello, friend.
The sun's a little bit blocked by the atmosphere out there. I'm waiting for everyone to start talking.
Finally, now get lost.
People only talk when I talk to them. Eventually, they'll all start talking. Then I know the script isn't jamming. But it's weird how I'll be playing around with the display settings in the game. Next thing I know, 5 hours have gone by in the game. So that's what happens when you spend like 20 minutes doing something. That's how fast the time flies in the game. Using a time scale of 20? I think that's the default for the game. I thought I was using time scale of 10. Maybe not. I'm gonna have to check that and see.
Hello, friend.
Smells like garlic.
I feel the same. I do not think I should make it.
Anyway, it felt like killing a dragon. I thought we could get to the, is it called Dragon's Tooth or something? Get there from here. I'm just acting like a crazy person running up a cliff. Because I can. Oh, I like these clouds up here. That's kind of cool. And then I found this guy, the Periite or whatever. Whatever's going on up here. Was his name Kesh or something?
Ah, a wanderer, yes. No, pilgrim, perhaps. You have come to commune with Periite, Taskmaster, and Blighted Lord, yes. Not everyone has the stomach required to entreat my lord. But Kesh likes you, friend. There is a way Periite may speak to us who will take him in. If you wish to commune with him, we'll need the incense. Yes, the incense. Fetch for me a deathbell flower, 1 silver ingot, a flawless ruby, and some vampire dust. Then I will show you how.
I was so shocked. I was totally shocked when I had all that stuff on me. That's never happened before.
Need something? Ah, have you? Let Kesh have them. Yes, yes, this will create a fine view.
I'm looking at Vilya like, can you imagine? What are the chances?
That should do. Now, inhale deeply.
I'm level 26 or something, so I should have a crap ton of stuff in my inventory. Anyway, this gave me a chance to try out this scene with this EMP.
Breathe deep, mortal. I would have you hear me well. So let these vapors fill your lungs.
Lydia's bored.
In a sense, but no more poison than a fool after too much wine.
So where are the rats? Usually there's rats I'm talking to.
I have watched you for some time, you know. The decisions you've made intrigue me. And I wonder if you are the proper agent for a task of mine.
The rats don't look too bad.
I sent a blessing to Mundus. A wasting plague that infected a scattering of Breton villages. One of my monks, the elf Orchendor, was sent to gather these afflicted. He shepherded them into Bathardoms for me, but has since lost his way. I will not stand for betrayal. I want you to go to Bathardoms and kill Orchendor in my name. So you have, mortal. Go now. Kill Orchendor.
I still need to look and see if there's a Daedric artifact from this quest. I need to make sure I get it. I need to get all the Daedric artifacts. What is that? Is that a dead saber cat, or just what's going on there? And then down below is usually where I kill a wolf on the way to, coming up here. There's that one spot where, like, a dark elf lady is killed at some altar. Somewhere down there is Mariel. She's a Forsworn follower. She hangs out down there. Can't see her. Let's go kill us a dragon.
Not far, not far. This one looks upon it on clear days. Look to the west, at the foot of the mountain. The dwarven ruins there. Bathardoms. Orchendor? Cash know him. He is an overseer, shepherd, gathers the afflicted, contains the festering wound. Orchendor and his afflicted are meant to stay.
Look at his eyes, they're all wide open.
Periite's command to cover the world with his blessing. Until next time.
Why are you looking at me like that?
I like this overcast, cloudy weather. Kind of cool. Adds depth to the sky. Oh. There's something. Which way? Which way to the dragon? Dragons! Yeah, so the reason why I deleted about 5,000 videos is because I got a letter from YouTube. They weren't exactly happy with one video of mine. I got penalized for 90 days for a video I've had on my channel for 7 years. They're just now getting around to letting me know this. And that was before I was even playing Skyrim.
You look tired. Don't you think we should take a break soon? Of course.
So if they would go after that video, I thought, well, I have a whole bunch of Skyrim videos.
Shall we continue?
They're far worse than what was going on in my it was a poser. It was a Poser 6 video.
What's on your mind?
A tutorial on how to make clothes for a Poser 6 character.
How can I serve you, my thane?
And you know, the character's naked until you put the clothes on. They weren't too happy about it. I can't help it.
You lead, I'll follow.
I was using Modo, so Modo, of course, makes Poser characters look like real people. So maybe YouTube thought it was a real person that was naked in the video. If someone from the future came to me and said, 7 years from now, this video is going to cause you to delete massive amounts of your other videos you have. Yeah, I would not have believed it. I would not have believed in this Skyrim thing they talk of. I was not even remotely interested in playing Skyrim 7 years ago. It was just the game was not at its best back then. This is a scripted dragon. It always skids. All the time. Every time. It always skids. It gets too predictable, this whole fight scene. I don't remember a bear being in here, though.
Victory.
Anyway, so I had like 5,000 videos, something like that, some crazy number. And, you know, most of them I didn't have to get rid of. But they were so old anyway, they were outdated. The videos didn't apply anymore to common everyday situations, events. So I thought, why do I still have these videos on my channel? Let's get rid of them. It took forever. It took a few days
Dearest
to do it.
Friend, I'm so happy that you are here.
Because you can only delete like 25 videos at a time. So it took some doing. I think I was listening to Pandora for a while I did it to make the time go by quicker. So I'm down to like a little over 100 videos now. So I just have to edit out stuff. I have to edit out more stuff in my Skyrim videos when I'm doing the dubbing, so I don't end up with a bunch of Skyrim videos on my channel that YouTube's gonna complain about later. In theory. I've seen worse stuff happening in other people's Skyrim videos. Way worse. And their YouTube doesn't go after them. And they have commercials in front of their videos too. So it's a double standard that YouTube's doing on people. I like that little smoke coming out of the, what are these things called? Dragon skids? Dragon skid marks? I think we have to go visit some Forsworn on the way back. Because there's like one or two bounties I have to do before I get back to Markarth. Who's fighting who? Who are these guys? Who's that guy? Oh! I like that voice. When he dies, he always goes, oh! So what else has been going on? Oh. A few days ago I bought a rice cooker. I was at a store in the kitchen department and I was starving and I saw these rice cookers and I noticed how cheap they are. They're only like, they start at like $10 for a rice cooker. $10. How does it work for $10? How does one of those work? So there's like $19, $29, $39, $49, $59,
of course.
$100 for a rice cooker. I'm looking at all the different ones and brands and what's the difference between a rice cooker and
so,
a crock pot?
Where are we going now?
Meanwhile, my stomach's growling. I'm starving. I felt like making some rice Anyway, I was looking at the box, and on the box they had rice, they had macaroni pastas, different rices, different, look like stir-fry food, steamed vegetables and stuff, chocolate cake. Somehow you can make chocolate cake with a rice cooker. So I'm like, okay, I'm buying it. I'll figure out how to be a gourmet chef after buying the thing.
Hey, look, a cave. Wonder what's inside.
'Cause, you know, I'm not a cook. I only eat what comes through my car window. I've made spaghetti in the past, but that was like 30 years ago. Well, that was a neat backhanded swing I did. I don't know how I must have been going sideways when I swung the sword. Right now I'm just doing a stress test, trying to make the game crash. It's usually what I do when I'm at sea level, and I'm flickering up and down above sea level. It makes wet and cold go a bit nuts. Is he in the water or isn't he in the water? Because I need to figure out if he's dripping water or not dripping water. Oh, another saber cat. Oh, this clipping to the... I hate clipping. Ooh! He got some licks in there. Usually, if my game's gonna crash, it's because a saber cat got hit by lightning and fireball and by me. And while it was staggered, while it was paralyzed, you know, that kind of thing. All those active effects get applied onto a saber cat at the same time. usually crashes the game. Ooh. The game almost locked up there. Just because I killed a goat. So that made me run up here. What loaded up here that would make the game do that? Like, what's so special about this place? More clipping, really? Oh, I see. This is the road back to Markarth. This is the opposite direction that Mananok takes when he leaves the prison and heads back to his Fortress of Solitude. Somewhere around here is Karth Wasten or something? What's the place called? So then I thought, well, I'll just run back to Markarth, see if I can get the game to crash. Usually, coming back here usually triggers or spawns a dragon or two along this road. Sometimes my game will crash. It did crash. Anyway, I killed the dragon. Once I loaded the game up, there was a dragon fight, and I killed it. And now we're here. Back in the day, my game would always crash when the courier was trying to give me a letter. I was always outrunning him, and eventually he would give up trying to find me and crash the game.
Good to have you by my side, friend. I need reliable people around. Excellent. You've done us a great service. Here is your reward. Good speaking with you.
Oh yeah, I thought there was two bounties. I guess not. Maybe I already did the quest where he wants me to find something for him, like a shield or something. Maybe I'm not respected enough yet.
I'm so glad that we're traveling to Eldegrin Sanctuary together. The Skyrim wilderness is so scary when you're all alone.
That's weird. She's not wearing her, she's not wearing all of her outfit. Why is that? Well, at least she's working. Let's get some guards to chase us.
Careful.
That's weird. Vilya showed up wearing just that outfit and nothing else. Oh, she's wearing a black robe thing.
People laugh things they don't believe.
Because she can't remember what outfit she's got on from. From cell to cell that we go into. I'm gonna accidentally chop somebody.
Traveling in the Reach is dangerous. You need a good carriage. Where do you want to go? Climbing back and we'll be off.
Yeah, I was curious. If I go to Riften, will my horse show up? I think my horse was killed by the dragon. Or a dragon.
You'll want to watch yourself in Riften. A lot of ways to get yourself in trouble in that town.
If it's alive, it will be there waiting for me in Riften.